It's my pleasure and a real honor to introduce tonight's speaker, Ramon Vilalta and Carmen Pigem. Thank you very much for being with us tonight. Ramon and Carmen, together with their partner, Rafael Aranda, are architects from the School of Architecture of the Vallès, about 1 hour from Barcelona. And since 1988, they have been working together under the name Rcr Arquitectes, although you might probably call them RCR. Since then, the work that they have produced has made them recipient of numerous awards, in fact, too many to list here, but to name just a few. They are Knights of the Order of the Arts and Letters of the French Republic, 2008. They are honorary members of the American Institute of Architecture, 2011. They are 2010, they are recipients of the International Belgian Building Awards, 2011. They are honorary members of the Royal Institute of British Architects, 2012. And they have also won the first prize of an overwhelming amount of architectural competitions, at least one or two every year since they founded their office. With exceptional years like 2010, when they won the first prize for 4 international competitions of architecture. The prolific work of RCR produces an architecture that responds in a very specific way to each unique problem, program, and context, producing an enormous variety of projects. However, their work has a series of recurrent themes and obsessions that make their architecture extremely unique. As Josep Maria Montaner puts it, Universo RCR. One of the main drivers of their work is a very particular relationship with nature, which has been very much inspired by the town where RCR has its headquarters, the town Olot, situated between the Pyrenees and the Mediterranean Sea, far from the speed of the big city and surrounded by a rich and beautiful landscape. Their architecture dialogues with nature through the study of light, air, sound, heat, materiality, landscape, texture, and it uses a language full of opposed terms and ambiguities. Their architecture is nature and is artifice, is material and immaterial, petrous, ethereal, open, closed, it is interior and exterior. In fact, the relationship between the interior and exterior is a common theme in their projects. Their architecture blurs the boundaries between inside and outside, using the filter and the membrane as a way of dissolving the limits. They capture space in ambiguous ways, dematerializing matter. They work with the roughness of direct materials like steel, glass, concrete, but they unconventionally dissolve the materials into light, translucency, reflections, environments, textures, producing a strong sense of place and identity, a space that is designed for the human perception, sensation, and emotions. We are thrilled to have them lecture tonight. Please join me in welcome RCR.
Thank you. Thank you. Maybe we can turn the light. Yeah, thank you. So, thank you for coming and thank you for inviting to us. So, I'm going to talk in English, but my English is so basic. And please do not hesitate to ask to me anything during the lecture. As so they said, this lecture will take place in a very casual place. So I thought maybe it could be something less than a lecture and also could be more like a conversation. So I want to show some drawings, some pictures to you. But also if you are interested in one project or another one, we can try to find it and to talk on it. So right now in the picture, you can see a model. This is a structure model for a lighthouse. It's the first national competition that we won. It was the first one. And it was just after our studies were finished. So for us, it's like our love baby, the baby that we prefer. because it represents the first step in our career. And it shows very well the principles of our way of doing architecture, our interest in sight and our interest in brief. So a lighthouse, if you look into a dictionary, it says it's a tower, ta-ta-ta. But in this case, we have thought, what is a lighthouse? And a lighthouse is a light. This light came from a fire on the beach to make a signal for ships. They were sailing on the sea. So what's a lighthouse? So a lighthouse is not a tower for us, it's a light. And in this case, also, the place was a very steep mountain, or very steep point in the coast. So the purpose were to put a light here, and it was coming from the other projects that were coming from a middle point of a steep mountain. So this, in a way, we think it's a very pedagogic project that shows very well our interest in brief, going deeper in concept and taking care about the site. So also to understand maybe our way of doing architecture, it's important to know where we live and where we work. So we live very far from here, in Spain, in Catalonia, in a small city called Olot, and this city is surrounded by a natural park, a volcanic natural park. So its landscape is very soft, with some hills, with a lot of vegetation, and in the rear you can see the Pyrenees. So it's a place very powerful for us because of these volcanoes, because there are a number of 40 of them, all of them extinguished, but they have a very strong presence, and they have made a very special landscape. And also in our place that we live, we have to say that there, when we are talking about nature, or when we are talking about landscape, it's not a wild landscape. It's always a landscape balance between nature and human. So humans there are really transformed this landscape. And when nowadays we see this landscape, we see a landscape that is a result from nature and humans. So we think this is a very important lesson to us, to understand the way to make interventions in the landscape. At the end you see one unit that you like and that you think this is natural, but it's not coming only from nature and it's not coming only from humans, it's both. It's a very balanced result. So we are after 25 years working together, so there we are very young, you see. So we took the name of the office as our first name. So it's Rafael, there, Carmen, and Ramon. So we are 25 years working together, so it's a good moment to make a review. Even on the work. No, we're growing, being older with our team. Of course, we are not only three, we are more than three, of course. Now you see a white hair. So after 25 years working, so we are much older. So right now we are working in a in a new office since 2008. And we take this picture with all of the team. And this is this new office. It's a very nice space. So it's a space that comes from an ancient foundry. Here, in this space, in this very historic space, bells and sculptures in bronze has been produced. So we have tried to keep everything and putting only the new items for our activity and trying to balance both, not only balance, but also to show the past of time. So you can, we can recognize every print that has these walls and the roofs and everything. These walls that explain time, explain the past of time. And also we have had these tables, cantilevered, and only to put some furniture, tables, and that's all. Trying to be in this space, to add one step more. It's like the landscape that I've told to you before. The landscape exists, this foundry exists, and then we add another step, another print, and that in the future could be continued. And also it's strange because also in this complex we have some exterior space, a little garden. So and also this shows the how important is for us the exterior spaces, how to make a strong relationship between interior and exterior. We like through the architecture to be protected from nature, but at the same time we want to live in it. So again, it's trying to balance. Architecture has born in order to be protected from nature, but in the past of times architecture has lost nature. So we try to put again together architecture and nature, so to be to feel protected from nature, but at the same time to have the feeling you are living in the nature. And also the main space for the foundry, we have kept not for the architecture activity, but for other cultural activities. Right now we have founded a foundation, a cultural foundation, in order to make different events and cultural programs. So we also understand architecture in a very waste, concept. So not only architecture it's to create the space, but also it's a very strong human value. So it has a very strong humanistic approach. So architecture is creativity, and this creativity could go wider than only spaces. We try to think about the space also around other subjects. So in the garden we have a pavilion, and we call it the dream pavilion, because there we can go to discuss some projects, to have some meetings, to feel isolated, to feel in a way in a space inside the nature where we can discuss very in a very not crowded, but very concentrated space. So now we know where we live and where we work. So where we were when we started and when we were young. So you know a little more about us. Let us explain to us now some tools that we used to use producing architecture. So the tools are very varied. So we always think any tool provide any information. So any tool provide a kind of information, and any tool help us in order to get the final result. So we like to use some watercolors in order to fix some concepts in a very easy but at the same time powerful way. And this watercolor could be from a concept, from a detail, doesn't matter. And this concept that, and this concept reflected in these watercolors, we try to keep it. And at the end, the architecture keeps this essence, keeps these concepts, explained in a very easy way. And also we use renderings, these 3D images. So the first time that a client has asked to us to produce one of them, we said, oh, it's horrible to do this, no? We don't want to do this, we don't like to do this. But we started to produce it, and even more and more we decided that it was also a useful tool. Because in a very easy way, we can try to find the atmosphere from the space. So we try from the watercolors to keep concepts. And from the renderings, we try to find the atmospheres of the spaces. If it's more light, or more dark, if it's a more soft texture or more hard one. And also trying at the end to get this 3D, to get a picture that links directly to these images, no? As this one, which it has been finished 2 weeks ago. And also with these renderings, it's nice to come into this atmosphere of the space, of these reflections and transparencies, lights, so that helps us a lot. And then also we use models, of course. Models to know and to understand the volumes, and also the techniques of the models could be so different, but it's trying to understand and to keep the volumes of the architecture. Maybe it has a more exterior way of the architecture. So we have the concept, then we have the interior and atmospheres, and from the model we have the exterior. And also materials are different. It depends if these models are more final or more in process. Also, the same building could have different models in different scales. And then you see, and then of course, then we are going to see a very precise drawings by AutoCAD, very precise in each millimeter. So it's important to know that because architecture, the first prototype is the final result. So this is something very, very heavy in a way, no? Because in industrial production, the industry produce many prototypes in order to have a final product. But in architecture, the final product is the first prototype. So we need to make a lot of approaches in order to make less mistakes as possible. So, for example, in this case, we have seen the model. The model shows the building or shows the construction, because at the end, when you are leaving these spaces, you only see this exterior part, because only this, because this part goes underground. So here we can see this project that tries to make a sense of place, because this project comes in the edge from the mountain to the valley, and at the end you see the sea. So it's just in this junction between the forest and the hill and the valley. You have a path, and you come into these spaces underground. But also when you are underground, you feel the air, you feel the light. So this is a project of a caves. It's a winery. So this space is the space where you go to taste the wine. So you are underground, so you don't have any light. You feel inside the earth. But when you arrive to this space, then you have the light and you have the air. Even in this space, the rains comes in. And then, for example, it's very different, no? This project came a lot from the site, to understand the site. And this one comes a lot from the brief. This is a kindergarten. So it's a project that talks about children, about toys, about play. But also we don't forget the site. So this project, it's very, because it's at the end of the slope street, you can see the roof. So we have tried to make really the roof as another facade. So this project is understood as a box of toys or as a box of pencils, a color pencils. So and it's a building that is made with a lot of pieces, metallic ones, and these pieces are like a cylinders, so they are round. And when children, because it's very common children to put her hand along the wall when they are walking on the street, so some of these pieces turn. So children touch the building and some pieces turn round. So the building react in a way with the children, establishing a relationship between children and it. And also when we are preparing spaces, it's really that everyone reacts in different way. So we prepare spaces for perception, but perception comes from our own background. So it's nice to see, for example, these pictures at all descriptive, but very sensual in a way. So this comes from a look from Mark Jasinski, who calls himself a poet of the images, and he found in the building or in the space the lights and the atmospheres and the corners that he likes, that attracts him. So we prepare spaces, we prepare buildings, but at the end the feeling of everybody is different. And this feeling comes from the own background related to this building. So it's really nice to see how people could react in different way in the building. So because answers come from a question, you are going to have a good answer if you make a good question. So you can ask, and also you can ask many things. It depends a lot of the intention, and it depends a lot of the look. So this shows in a way how a look could provide another way of understanding a building. And also this project, it explains a sense of place again, and also a sense of a vocation. So in a small village, long time ago, there were a theater called La Lira, and they demolished this theater, and they asked it to have a covered plaza. A square cover. So at the same time they were asking for this, we decided also to provide a path to cross the river. So which is nice at the end in this project, it's to understand that this square, this public square, this plaza, it's a space for a village, but also, it's a space that provides the scenario, the scenography, the setup for the people who live in this village. So people moving in this space and crossing this river are like the actors in this theater. So it's a vocation of remembering that we try to don't forget making this new space, adding again a new step in this, in the story or in the history of this place. So we try to link nature and also the city in this space, link it in a very strong way, and also having different kinds of light during the day. And people who are moving there, crossing the river, they are like actors in this, in a way, a vocation of the theater. So we always try to, in architecture, not try to put our ideas on a building. We try to understand the site and to understand the brief in order to produce something unique for this place that you cannot remove. You cannot take this project and to move to any other place. This project fits exactly to this place. So, now I'm going to explain to you in a more, how can I say, more conventional way a project. No? Right now we have shown to you some ideas, some approaches in order to understand different concepts. Eh? Not so easy, but trying to. But right now we are going to start explain a project in a very common way. So, really nice. To make an space for celebrations. And we were in this brief trying to make a party in the forest. So for making a construction for parties, we have decided as a brief to take the reference a party in a forest, like for example this Musique Artillerie de Manette à Paris. Also in our village, in Olot, a party long time ago along the river, trying to make a party in a forest, no? In this sense of, okay, it's a party, but we are not going to be inside a restaurant, inside a hall, to be in a way in a forest, in an exterior space. And also in Barcelona, no? A party long time ago, you can see about the dresses of people. No? So only about these pieces, how this produces a sense of place, no? And also a sense of fiesta, of party. No? So we put these pieces, these fabric pieces. They are not in fabric, but it seems to be. And in a place that it's surrounded by a lot of warehouse in a very not nice part of the city. So we decided to be a little under, a little protected about these surroundings. So we feel more down and we have this cover making this sense of place. And also making some little patios with these trees coming up, making this forest. Now these trees are growing, we hope they make a bigger shadows on the roof. And because we have removed a lot of a stone, and then we remove this stone, we cut it in small pieces, and these stones come again to the place for the patios and also for the floor and for the slopes. So, and also this space, so it's a forest. In this concept of forest, we have also this different filtering. So we produce spaces, it depends of how many people will be in the party. So maybe it's a party about 100 or maybe 500. So you never know the number of people. So we have tried also about all of these patios to adjust the space that you need according of the number of people. So you see this slope coming down with this stone coming from the side and this roof. And the shape of the roof comes from what? From the width of the tubes. So this roof is made by metallic tubes hang it from one side to the other side, and then from its own width they take this shape. So it's a shape coming from the material. You see the plan, no? You come and then you have different spaces with all of the trees making this forest, no? This forest party place. And also with a lot of textures. This is concrete, but in a very different way of showing it. So we also try in our projects to use as few materials as possible, but at the same time, when we decide one material for one project, we try to, this material shows itself in a very, very different registers, in a very big variety of finishing. So we have one material, but not shown in the same way, but shown in many, many different ways. Here you can see Rafael trying to get the final texture himself. And also a lot of plans, a lot of detailed plans, no? How these tubes, how the light, how the air. So we need some concept drawings, but at the same time we need a very precise drawings, because architecture, despite this picture, we don't do by ourselves. So we always have to give some information to other people who are going to do this. So it's very important how to try to make drawings that people could understand, that people could build. And then because these patios are closed, not by glass, by plastic, an FT plastic that gives us a very dense light, a very not sharp shadows or sharp reflections, but more dense, more ambiguous in a way. And then for the part of the toilets, we also down there from the slope, and also we have natural light for the corridor and also for the space. This is this corridor, and this corridor also it's open, so it's very ventilated. And for the restrooms, for a party restrooms, it's very important. And then you can see this toilet where you go to to wash your hands. You see this slope coming down, you see the air, you feel the light. And then here you see some details, and this kind of reflections and this kind of lights, these mixtures between the stone, the tree, the plastic and the light. So light, it's another material that works in the space. And it's always a very nice material, because it changes continuously. It depends on the season, on the hour. It's not boring. It changes every time. It can surprise you at any time. And after the rain, this roof looks like a sky reflection. And now we are finishing two buildings in France, where we are now working with some projects. This one is a piece in the ruins of a castle. And again, we think we try always, I told to you just before, no? We try to always to make always another step in the landscape, in the existing buildings, in the existing city. So again, in this castle, we have tried to make a program and a project that fits into the ruins. So this castle has these four walls creating a patio, and we try to put program in both sides in order to make a really alive patio. So we are inside of this patio of this castle, and doing this, we make this patio very alive. So this this project, it's for an art center around the theme of la cuisine, of the kitchen. And also they prepare spaces for this, and also they prepare spaces for artist stages. So it's nice to see the power of these ruins and how the project doesn't destroy these ruins, but at the same time they touch them. So it's always this relationship to be there and at the end to have a very good balance. So this is the section that shows the main level of the patio, and we keep this window in order to not cut the landscape view. And here we have a room for some lectures or presentations. But we also try not to lose the view, because now, because it's a ruin, we have this view, and we want to have program at this level, but not losing the view. And this is the space for the artist. It's called the space of the donjon. And here you see this patio full of life and with different way of doings. The kitchen, exhibitions, this is coming up. Some concerts in summer. So we can recognize the old and new. But at the end, what we try is that it's possible not to divide, to integrate this as it is. So it's not, again, something that you cannot divide. At the end, what we try is to have a final image that goes together. And the last project that we want to present to you is a museum. So it's really nice to make a museum project. and this museum that it's going to be finished at the end of the year. It has a long story. This is in France, in a village called Rodez, and it's the Villa Natal from the most famous painter in France still alive, which name is Soulages, Pierre Soulages. And they wanted to make a museum in this place, which is a park called Foirail, and it's in a very special also landscape situation. Here there is a river surrounding the city, and here it's the most prominent part of it. And here there is the cathedral. And along of this, there is a park. But the city is very down there at this level. So it has a very strong slope. So the artist wanted to have a museum in the garden. And we didn't want to cut or to occupy this park and this space or this garden, because we think it's a very important space for the city. So we decided to put the museum there, solving the topographic problems from the down level of the city and the upper level, and also getting at the same time this feeling of the museum in the garden. We have tried also not to lose the main views from this neighborhood to the cathedral or to the other space, trying not to lose also the long landscape. And also this museum comes with a collection from the painter who has made two donations to the museum, and soon we hope there is going to be the third one and the last, and probably the last. And they want also to make the story of his painter and the story of his tools or how can I say, types of painting or types of producing painters. So in a very pedagogic way. So there is a many variety of painters, and when it's coming, no, these were older, no, you see 55 or 49 or 46, and now we are coming 71 73, so it has, you can see his evolution in painting. And now they have the Outre Noir, these are the most famous paintings from him, and we hope at the end they are going to come also into the museum. 74. And also in his painting, we think we have some kind of relationship between our architecture and his painting. So it was very important for us to produce or to think or to make a museum for him. No? So, and also all the process has been very interesting because we have had a very strong relationship with him. And also this museum, he wants, the painter wants to have three main poles of force. In one side, his paintings, of course. Another one, the architecture. The other one, to have also a very important temporary exhibition, a temporary space a space for temporary exhibitions, in order to make alive the museum, and also to have a very important chef. So the restaurant for the museum has been, will be drive, but a 3-star Michelin chef in France. So they want that this museum also is a very alive place with a lot of ingredients, no? With a lot of things that make it alive. Some, he's very old, he's him, and his wife is always with him. They are close to their 75 wedding anniversary, so. And they go also to the site supervision. And this museum, because also they wanted that the museum was only done in one floor, we have down there the pieces, the store floor, and then the museum is in one floor, but the entrance of the museum, it's a little up. And here you see also these technical plans. Very precise. This is the roof. And most, you see, it's the same. This, sorry, no, sorry, 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 sorry. This is the technical plan from the main floor, or from the entrance, not the main floor. And here it's more in terms of architecture to understand it. And then it's more in a way to communicate how it works. So also in this kind of drawings, we have different types of it, no? This way of drawing the pieces. So this is the entrance of the museum. And then we have in the same space, the space for temporary exhibitions, but this is down there. And on the left, it's for the administration part. And on the right, we have a small piece for lectures in a bridge over the street, the stair street coming from down to up in the city. And here we have the piece of the restaurant, this restaurant that will be run or directed by a very important chef. Again, more technical, more architectonical, and more in a way to explain. So down there we have the common space, and then we have pieces prepared for a special paintings and for a special moments. This one is the more, it's the piece, the highest piece and the narrowest piece. This is because it's a piece prepared to keep an amount of work of soulage that has that he has prepared for making some not windows, but I don't have the work, some kind of windows for a cathedral. So this some vitrals. I don't have the name in English. No, but the church, they have these windows, but they are not windows with this kind of glasses. So they make a very interesting piece of making these glasses for a church, for a cathedral, and they make 8 years work on this. So they wanted to keep all of these preliminary works to be in this piece. And they are very tall and they are very big. And this is down there to for the las reservas. And how this museum it takes this sense of place. So we are in this park, and we try to be very, very low in order to keep the landscape, and also to cut, to frame this landscape in order to get it more. Because when you see everything, you see, but you don't really see. No, sometimes when you frame it, you put in relevance what you have to see, and how different this museum looks from the park or from the down city, which feels from down it feels more powerful, like if because we are in the top of a slope, like the erosion has make erosions in the site, in the land, and only some rocks can stand, that the rocks that cannot be erosioned. And how important is to work about light, and also how sections shows most of the time more than the floor plans, the difficulty in order to have a clean final image, and which to see the work of having this. You know, this section, for example, it's the entrance. This is the entrance, and here you see the main temporary exhibitions space, and how this light come into the space. This is most the common space with the administration part for the staff, and here is the part for these lecture rooms, like in a bridge over the stair street. How to provide all of this in order to control the natural light in this space. And that happens in many parts of the building, with a lot of details, a lot of, you know, we have to try that, as I said to you on the beginning, trying to find out the way of the final product. It's the first prototype. But then the space start to appear, and then this magic light at the end, when the floor it will be finished, you know, that gives you a very special space, and you don't know how the lights come, how the beauty could, in a way, be fixed on there. I'm sure this is made by a team, not only by three. That's all. Thank you very much.
Yes, I have one very technical one. So if you can go back to your drawings, to the carpet, to the roof, I want to know how do you construct that? How do you make it? With the ATFE, where is the ATFE exactly? And where you don't mind to...
No. It's auto-saving right now.
Yes. Yeah, that one. No, maybe... More in the detail, Carmen.
More in the detail.
Yeah, that one.
That one.
Yeah. Where is the ATFE?
Where is
in the roof? The ATFE is where it's placed. Could you explain a little bit about this detail?
About this detail. Yes. Here there is the tubes. Here there is the tubes. You know, and this one from this we have a piece coming up, and then here we have the piece of the roof. This is in a plastic roof, and then from this we have this light coming down. So one, yes, one, no, we have light.
The plastic
is on the top. Is here.
How is it?
It's fixed in these pieces that come from the tube. No, it's better maybe to see here. No, how this comes up and then this goes in this direction.
I have a less technical question. You talked about, thank you for the very refreshing lecture. You talked a little bit in the beginning about the watercolors. I was interested to hear some more about how you collaborate, the three of you collaborate in the beginnings of your projects.
We, for the projects always in the beginning, for us it's very important to visit the site. So, We go together to visit the site, and having the brief, we try to understand what fits in this site. Sometimes it's very difficult to explain this, no? I used to explain this using a comparison. For example, when we are in face to an alphabet that we don't know, for example, if you are in front of an Arabic alphabet or a Chinese alphabet or a Japanese alphabet, if you don't know them, you only see nice drawings, nice lines. And when you are in front of an alphabet that you know, for example, our alphabet, you cannot see an L as a line or an O as a round. You read, even if you don't understand the language, you read. You read O, L, I, doesn't matter. So we are very used to go to read the landscape, and we say that in a way, we are confronted with an alphabet that we know. And sometimes it's difficult to explain, no? But we go to a site and we understand a lot of things, and the project starts from there. And then we have to produce a space for a brief, but in this place. Because architects, we have to answer what we have to do, and where we have to do this. So from the site, we take a lot of answers from it. And from the brief, we try to go deeper in concept, how we can do. And then with having these two main questions or these two main informations, architects have to produce how we are going to do this in this place. So we, for us, it's very important that the starting point that we do together, and also some crucial points, or any time that one of us asks to the other ones, please have a look on this. So it's very important, the starting point, and then in different moments that anyone thinks it's important to share. It's nice to think about the shared creativity. So he says it's important to, he says it's important that shared creativity allows a group of people, not necessarily extraordinary, to produce extraordinary results. So it's in this concept of shared creativity. So we try to do this. And after 25 years, that works. Thank you to you.